far the start of the weekend has...
Patrick Wayne Swayze was born on August 18, 1952, in Houston, Texas. He was one of five children, with two sisters and two younger brothers, one of whom is actor Don Swayze.
Growing up in Houston, Texas, Patrick Swayze got a perfect mix of both his parents, and it played out throughout his career. His dad grew up on a ranch, was very macho and masculine, and ended up being a draftsman. And his mother ran a ballet school and was a choreographer. So Patrick went into dance and had the artistic and the graceful aspect of her. On the other side, his dad was a macho cowboy. And so Patrick had the best of both. Patrick was a tough kid, but he got teased a lot because he was also a ballet dancer. And a lot of times the other kids would say, hey, what's in your bag, Patrick, your ballet shoes? And so he got into a lot of fights growing up, but he also learned to defend himself.
Ballet gave me a level of timing and flexibility and agility that made any sport come easy.
In high school, if there was something physical to do, Patrick Swayze was doing it. He was in football, he studied gymnastics, and he was still dancing as well. He had a scholarship to play college football, but a knee injury ruined that, so instead he went to New York to study dance with the esteemed Joffrey Ballet. Patrick Swayze was only married once. He met his wife, Lisa, when they were both teenagers. He was 18 and she was 14, and he spotted her while he was working at the local roller rink. And she was also a student in his mother's ballet school at the time. Patrick's mother wasn't too keen on them getting together because Lisa was one of her most talented students, and she didn't want her son distracting her.
Like most young performers, Patrick struggled for a while, and even took some modeling jobs.
One of the first times Patrick Swayze was paid to perform was a job playing Prince Charming at Disneyland. And one of his Cinderellas was actually Michelle Pfeiffer. Patrick made his Broadway debut in the musical Grease, taking over for the lead part of Danny Zuko. And not long after that, he made his film debut in a roller disco movie called Skate Town USA.
I was dancing on skates. I was a leader of a roller skate gang. It was a wonderful quality piece of celluloid.
Now, the film was a big bomb, but people remember Patrick.
So Kevin Thomas and the LA Times and all these other journalists went crazy for me.
One critic compared him to Rudolph Valentino and said, not since Rudy have we seen such a confident display of male sexuality.
In the breakout hit, The Outsiders, directed by Francis Ford Coppola, Patrick was part of an ensemble cast that became a who's who of Hollywood, including Rob Lowe, Tom Cruise, Matt Dillon, C. Thomas Howell, Ralph Macchio, and Emilio Estevez.
Patrick was a good 10 years older than most of them, so when they were working on the movie, he became a bit of a leader and would teach the other guys how to fight, how to do gymnastics, and even how to jump on freight trains.
In 1987, Patrick landed what was for him the perfect role. Johnny Castle was a tough guy who could also dance.
Great sex, a lot of heat, and great dancing. It really was a phenomenon. I think it touched people's hearts. And it's the girl that has something special in her heart that gets the guy, not just because she's on some bikini poster somewhere.
There were a number of iconic scenes from Dirty Dancing that were never supposed to be part of the original movie. That moment where Patrick runs his hand up Jennifer Grey's arm and she can't stop laughing, that was actually what was happening on the set, and they just kept it in.
It becomes obvious those times when a heat or a chemistry comes off, and it really happened with Jennifer and I.
And also that scene where Baby and Johnny are falling in love and crawling across the floor to each other, that too was a totally spontaneous moment.
When it happens, it's something special. You know, when the audience reads fire in your eyes and a passion, it gets them going. He's an incredibly emotional being, you know, and...
Would you be willing to sign such a document?
Sure, I'll sign it. When do I get the money?
Tonight. Now, Roger. I have a
Medicare.com helpline. Our